And we're back, and this time I'm going to show you how to recreate this effect in Adobe Photoshop. Let us just use a flower image for that. And I'm going to create the Instagram icon first. Let me use an ellipse, no fill color, but a white stroke. We will play around with the size of the stroke anyway later on, so forget about that for now. Just hold shift when you drag it to have a perfect circle. Afterwards, press Ctrl A and use the move tool. You will have a top menu that you can use to align it. We'll do the same for the rounded rectangle. Make sure you've got your properties menu set up. If you can't see that, go to Windows properties. And then both of these layers are selected. So I just clicked on both holding shift. And then I change the size of the stroke. 80 should be fine. And for the rounded rectangle, you need this link icon to be activated. And then change one of these values for the roundness. Maybe 300 is a good value. We need another circle, but this time we want to have a fill and no stroke. Let me drag that holding shift. I don't have to go to the top menu here as the stroke is big enough to fill it, but you can fill it if you want and get rid of the stroke. It creates the same design. Let me move the original around a little bit. That should be a good position. I've grouped the Instagram icon, so I've selected all of the layers, then pressing Ctrl G. That way I can make them visible or invisible at the same time. Go to the layer of the photo again, then use the quick selection tool. The selection does a good job here, but on the edges I need to add some details. If you hold Alt, you can get rid of parts of your selection. Otherwise, with a left click, you will add parts to the selection. And now I'll just click on layer mask on my folder for the Instagram icon, and then I press Ctrl I to inverse it. And this is basically the effect. But I'm not happy with the position here, so let me reposition that. I'll simply right click on the layer mask and delete it. I press Ctrl T to resize the original, and I move it around. And now I repeat the process. So once again, go to the original layer, use the quick selection tool, go over the edges, then make the folder visible again. Click on layer mask, press Ctrl I. That looks way better. And this is how you can recreate this typical Instagram effect in Adobe Photoshop. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.